The Philippine Health Department says it still cannot say for sure whether the increase in COVID cases can be attributed to the eased face mask rule. Last week, President Marcos allowed the optional wearing of face masks in outdoor settings. Amid the spike in infections, the DOH stresses the importance of maintaining a low number of severe and critical COVID cases. A Filipino health expert disagrees with U.S. President Joe Biden's declaration the pandemic is over, at least in America. Dr. Maricar Limpin points out COVID numbers in the U.S. are still up. She says it is more accurate to say the end of the pandemic is in sight, like what the World Health Organization said.
That is one of the, you know, frustrating things, no, to hear that, you know, for people who are not really battling on the ground, no, to be hearing them that they are already seeing the end of the pandemic. We are already seeing that we are very near the end of the pandemic, but as Dr. Tedros also said, no, we cannot be complacent at this point. That is also the last statement. So I think we need to give emphasis to that we cannot be complacent, that we need to continue, you know, whatever we are doing in order to provide maximum protection to our people.
As for the country's sugar supply, officials expect prices of the basic commodity to stabilize by November. The Board of the Sugar Regulatory Administration says prices may range between 70 and 80 pesos per kilo once refineries operate in full swing. The SRA assures Filipinos the country has enough sugar supply. It recently authorized the importation of up to 150,000 metric tons of refined sugar.
Right now, we have in stock about 134,000 metric tons. And the total refined as of now is around 143,000 metric tons. So we have a demand of about 6,222 in raw withdraw and about 6,899 with refined
per week.
That's a per week demand. So once the imported comes in, it's going to stabilize the whole pricing mechanism. It will stabilize because everybody will start milling already, and barring another typhoon or whatever, like Odette or that, the canes are looking good. So hopefully if it continues, the trend continues, we will have more sugar than what we estimated.
The Philippine Agriculture Department looking at a possible oversupply of garlic in some areas. That's after Batanes Province and a town in Occidental Mindoro sought the agency's help as their garlic supplies start to rot amid a supposed lack of buyers.
Some of the garlic that was produced was also for planting materials. In Batanes, if I may say, that our regional office in Region 2 bought 20 metric tons of garlic as planting material. So it's not only for marketing, but also for production purpose. So what we're looking at right now is the volume of production of our garlic farmers. And at the same time, we will be looking into having more institutional buyers to be able to get into contract growing with our farmers.